Hi guys. So we've made another stopover just by the lake, by the shores of the lake. We just wanted to have a feel of the water. We've been here for 2 days, but we haven't gotten time to come by the shores just to have a feel of the water, see what it looks like from a close range. As you can see, Khadija is having her sweet time. The water is very clear, as you can see. The stones are a bit slippery because of the continuous close contact with water. But the water itself is fairly warm because of the harsh weather conditions over here. So it stretches all the way. There are some islands. Good morning, guys. So we've just left. We're just leaving Galan. We left. We checked up the hotel at 6:30. We are headed out to Sikilei National Park. It's about 104 kilometers away. So we've just stopped for a bit just to take in the sunrise. Some last camera. Not sure how much more you can see in Sikilei National Park. But I guess we'll figure it out as we go there. So, it's probably going to be like this for the rest of the trip. It's not so... You might notice that the surroundings don't have so many buildings or homes. It's because they choose to live in within communities. They pick up a place, that is the local. They pick up a place and they set up camp there. Yeah, that's where they build their quarters and that's where they live. Behind that this beautiful sunrise, we want to take a couple of shots before we continue our trip down the city.
Hi guys, I hope you had a lovely Christmas. We decided to travel around Christmas Day from Nairobi to Turkana, Loyo Ngalani, and on Christmas Day, and there was a huge traffic jam on Thika Road. Anyway, the traffic managed to reduce around Kenol, and then it further reduced at Karatina. Yes, it seems everybody was rushing home for Christmas on their Christmas Day. Nairobi guys, eh? So we arrived at Samburu Ngurunix. We arrived at Nanyuki around 4 p.m. Not 4 p.m. We arrived at 2 p.m. We had lunch, bought a few things, and then left for Isiolo. We left Nanyuki at 4 p.m. on 25th. We reached Isiolo around 7 p.m. By the time we had Ololokwe, it was around 9, and we reached Ngurunit Lasamu campsite at around 12 at night. We're always late. I don't know why. We always arrive at our destination at night, but we are used to that. We quickly set up. We had a lovely time at Ngurunit, and from Ngurunit we went to Loyo Ngalani. Those distances, they're crazy, crazy. We spent almost how many hours from Ngurunit, from the tarmac?
Around 3 hours.
The tarmac, from the tarmac at the highway, Moyale Highway, to Ngurunit was like 70 kilometers off-road with very bad corrugations. And then from Ngurunit to Loyo Ngalani, it is 159 kilometers. So we left around 10. We arrived at Loyo Ngalani at 6, just in time for the most incredible sunset. So we stayed at Loyo Ngalani for 2 days, the day before yesterday and then yesterday. So today we're heading further north to Sibiloi National Park. It's incredible, 154 kilometers of road. So far so good, the cars behaved very well. Though it has a check engine, I don't know what happened to that, but one other interesting bit about Loyo Ngalani is we found mostly foreigners. Then there were hardly any Kenyans who venture to these sites. I don't know what's up, Kenyans. You can come here, your own products, RAV4 can do it, Vanguard can do it, even a Subaru can do it.
Everything about this place is lovely, but one thing about this place, it's too hot, very, very hot. If you need to come on this side, you need to carry lots and lots of water. Yes, because I don't think there is any place you can buy water. You just need to sort yourself before coming to this place. We are enjoying every bit of our stay, from all the way to Nairobi, Nanyuki, Samburu, then Loingalani, as we head to Sibiloi. Yeah. So stay tuned as we continue to show you our passion for travel.
Thank you.